लाइक वो सास भी कभी बहू थी कि यू नो आइए हमारे घर में आ जाओ सब्सक्राइब करो प्लीज. Hi, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my wedding makeup look. Just kidding, I'm not getting married, not anytime soon. But welcome to my first ever bridal makeup tutorial. I have never ever done a bridal makeup tutorial on my channel. I've done so many makeup looks, but I felt like there was something missing for the bride out there. So this is a bridal makeup tutorial that will have you covered all bases. Even if you're somebody who's getting your makeup done on your own, you will know what to do, how to learn what features you want to emphasize, what features you want to camouflage. And also if you're getting your makeup done from a bridal makeup artist, then you will know what you should advise them according to how you learn your features. So I'm going to take you through the process as well as give you a lot of makeup options and tips and tricks that you can keep in mind to look flawless and have a long wearing makeup throughout your bridal shoot. This would make sure your makeup lasts really long and you'll be looking flawless in all those photos. Your skin will be looking like a freaking filter. So if you want to know how I got ready for my fake wedding, then continue watching. But if this is the first time you've come out to my channel, then hi, I'm Sara. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. Take a moment, hit that subscribe button, join the Sara squad. I'm sure you'll have a great time here. And also don't forget to hit the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. And with that, we can dive straight into this. Alright, let's begin with skin prep first. Number one very important tip is do not forget your skincare. And number two is do not experiment with something you never have before. All your bridal facials and bridal treatments and whatnot for your skin, make sure you're doing it all 15 days before your wedding. Like nothing within 15 days of your wedding. Like when it was my sister's wedding, I didn't let her do anything for 30 days within her wedding. So that you're not subjecting your skin to something it has not been subjected to before. When a sari bookings jo shaadi ki sab cancel karni padegi if your skin reacts to something. So always make sure to stick to a skincare routine you have all these years, even if that means just that one single moisturizer you've been using. It's completely all right. So the moisturizer I like to use under my makeup right now is the oil free ultra moisturizing lotion from Cosrx, and this is a great one. It nourishes my skin and it also has birch sap, so it's like a little bit sticky, so it gives me a very good nice sticky base for my makeup. It's also oil free, so I'm oily skin type. So I really like it. You can get it on Limmel's Connect and you can use my code SARA10. So you'll get like a 10% discount. Just apply moisturizer thoroughly. If you want to do a serum, you can go ahead do a serum. The one skincare step that I would skip only on my wedding day would be sunscreen. Like I would not apply sunscreen underneath bridal makeup, because I know you're gonna be like in the sun and out there if it's an outdoor wedding all day long, and your skin might be subject to damage. But sunscreen can also cause a lot of flashback in photos, that is like that white cast that you can feel in photos. So just that one day I will let my sunscreen go. All my skincare fanatics might come at me, but that's what I would do. So I'm just recommending to any bride out there ki wo ek din tum sunscreen ko jaane do and bahut sara moisturizer lagao, kyunki lambe ghante makeup pehna hai to skin has to breathe underneath, and the more your skin can breathe and hydrate, it will not dry out, and so your makeup will not look dry and cakey and not start cracking up. So lather your moisturizer really well. That will make all the world of a difference. And if you get puffy eyes in the morning, like before your wedding, if you have an early morning wedding, like a Maharashtrian wedding or a South Indian weddings are early in the morning, and if you feel like your face is really puffy, then you can use like one of those glass rollers. Dot & Key does one of them, which is what I used last night to just de-puff my skin completely and take away any excessive like water retention your skin might have, so your skin looks really nice and supple in the morning. At this point, just apply a little lip balm as well. I'm using the one by Body Shop. This is their Born Lippy Strawberry Lip Balm. Just make sure your lips are hydrated, because then throughout your makeup, your lips can stay hydrated. And then end mein tumko lipstick lagana hota hai. Now for primer, you want to have long wear, longevity in your makeup, wherein you're not secreting oils from your T-zone. But also you want to look glowy and glamorous in all those shots that your photographer takes. So using a combination of a pore minimizing primer and like a strobe cream would be perfect for you. The pore minimizing primer I'm using is by My Glam. This this is their Tinted Perfection Base Primer and Pore Minimizer. All the makeup I'm recommending in this video is also makeup that I've tried and loved and I recommend, and is the makeup I would use if I was getting married, like tomorrow. I'm not, but if I was getting married, this is the makeup I would use, and I would 100% do my own makeup. I just feel like I've been working on my face for 4 years. I know what my face likes and doesn't like. So for the pore minimizing primer, less is more. Thoda sa amount lo, zyada lene se kuch bhi farak nahi padne wala hai. And massage it in your T-zone. All of us have pores. You cannot reduce them. You cannot decrease its size. You can minimize its appearance. And before makeup, you can of course fill it up. So that's what a pore minimizing primer helps to do. It just creates that filter. Can you see how like I was sweaty and shiny over here, and now it's just filled up and like looks a little filtered. So that's what it helps to do. Some other great recommendations for pore minimizing primers are the Lakme one, the Absolute Blur Primer, and the Inside Cosmetics one. These are like much more affordable. For the glowy part of it, I'm using the Lakme Lumi Cream. This is a new product. It's like a moisturizer with highlighter. It's pretty much what the MAC Strobe Cream does. If you have the MAC Strobe Cream, great. You can roll with that also. Again, less is more. Do not take too much of this. And first start with just the high points of your face. This adds that shiny highlight sort of moisturizer. But it's also like a skincare product. So you can apply it all over your face. Like on your cheeks, on your forehead, and blend it nicely in. Kuch bhi lagate samay na, just pat into your skin. To isse tum thode uth bhi jaoge aur thoda blood supply bhi increase ho jayega face ko. Skin is nice and prepped, so I'm going to let some time pass by so that it soaks in. But of course, we won't waste this time. We'll jump on to the eye makeup. Eye makeup I'm doing before my base makeup, because if I use glitter, if I use shimmer or anything in my eyeshadow falls on my face, then that will look very bad in my makeup and in my photos on my wedding day. So just always practice doing your eye makeup and then your base makeup. Colored contacts make the world of a difference to any eye look, any makeup look, and it looks so good on brown skin tone. So I love wearing colored contacts. You'll always see me do that. So the colored contacts I use is from the brand Aqua Color. This is their Mystery Hazel variant, and that's what I'm gonna wear right now. I just want you all to know, if you're not comfortable wearing lenses, you don't have to go ahead and do it. I'm super comfortable since I always do it. So agar tumko practice karna hai apni shaadi ke ek mahina pehle ke tum lenses pehno, to you can practice it, because it'll look really good. See how different I look like just with this lens. It adds so much dimension to your eye, and then when you do eye makeup, it stands out. Aur abhi mujhe bahut dhundla dikh raha hai, so I'm gonna wear in both. Okay, now my eyes look really nice with the lenses. I've chosen this Mystery Hazel color because it has this green undertone, jo mere jewelry ko bahut compliment karega, because I'm wearing like green kundan jewelry. So just make sure that if you're using like a red jewelry set, then you can use something with a brown undertone so that it ties everything together. The eye look I'm choosing to do today is a brown glittery eye look, which is something that will go with every single lehenga. Like most of the Indian brides do end up wearing maroon or red on their wedding day. Yeah, I know a lot of people are switching to pastel options, but this is something that will go with everything and is also universal to skin tone. It's something that looks super flattering on my skin tone, and you can play around a little bit as per your colors of your lehenga. First things first, you have to just hide these hyperpigmented eyes, all the veins and everything, so you need concealer. The concealer I'm using is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewinder Eraser Eye. Just going to apply a little bit of this to conceal any darkness I have and provide like a smooth canvas to my eyes. Taking my sponge, I'm gonna blend this concealer nicely and also shape out the shape of my brows while I do that. Just make sure you're not a bride on the rush. You are taking your own sweet time to do your bridal makeup. And even if you're getting it done from a makeup artist, give them that own sweet time to do your makeup. My favorite palette to use is the Morphe X Jaclyn Hill. No matter what the occasion, you have a color for every single occasion. I've like used and abused this palette so much. And even if you're a bride who wants to invest in this, you can, because later on also tumko bahut kaam aayega ye palette. Aur ab to easily India mein available hai. So I'm going to start by taking this neutral shade that I've literally hit pan on, because this is a great shade to just set this concealer in place, at the same time add some dimension to your crease also. So I'm just gonna pack it all in. It's gonna pick up so much more pigmented because of the concealer. Can you see? The shadow on first application is only so pigmented, which does not happen with a lot of palettes. So less is more. You just have to take less amount and keep blending. I'm going in packing motions. I'm not wind swiping right now. Just gonna pack this shadow as like a base to start working on. Next, I'm taking this maroon shade. I'm gonna take very less of this. I'm taking it on a pack 1-2-2 brush. तो इसका थोड़ा सा pointed सा tip है और इसको मैं outer as well as inner corner में slowly slowly blend करूँगी. This is like a maroon brown which is complementing my lehenga shade. So I really like that. Build it up. Now see the strokes I'm taking. They are small, small, small windswiper strokes and I'm just concentrating to the outer corner. Same thing I'm gonna do on the inside so that it looks big in photos, because in a lot of photos my eyes look really small. So hooded eye people, you have to be sure of what you want. Even my sister has hooded eyes and I had to go ahead and tell the makeup artist what would look good on her so that she knew that okay, this is how we want to play with eyeshadow. Otherwise your eyeshadow game will not be strong during your wedding and you really don't want that after spending all that money. You don't have to worry about messing up the edges. Even if your edges are not sharp, it's okay. Just keep on taking small, 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 small strokes and blending your eyeshadow. क्योंकि बाद में तो कंसीलर फाउंडेशन सब आने ही वाला है बेस मेकअप पे. तो जस्ट वर्क ऑन ब्लेंडिंग द आई शेडो रियली वेल. आई एम गोना गो बैक विद दैट ब्राउन शेड वी टुक एंड जस्ट क्लीन अप द ब्राउ बोन पोर्शन. जस्ट हैव टू डू दैट टू ब्लेंड ऑल द कलर्स इन. नाउ दैट आई हैव अचीव्ड द शेप आई एम गोइंग फॉर, आई एम गोना डीपन दिस आउट थोड़ा सा और डार्क करेंगे. उसके लिए आई एम यूजिंग दिस डार्क ब्राउन शेडो ऑन अ वेरी स्मॉल कफ्स एंड लैशेज CS05 ब्रश. एंड इसको एकदम केयरफुली खाली मैं लैश लाइन के पास डालूंगी टू गिव दैट स्मोकी इफेक्ट ऑन ओनली द आउटर कॉर्नर, नॉट पुटिंग इट ऑन द इनर कॉर्नर एट ऑल. सो लाइक अ फॉल्स विंग, लाइक विंग आईलाइनर कैसे बनाते हैं ना, वैसी आई एम लाइक स्ट्रोकिंग इट. If you can appreciate the difference, thoda sa, it's become a little cat-shaped. Alright, now for the main lid action, I'm gonna take this very nice coppery orange glitter. This is one of my favorite shimmer shades in the palette. Shimmer, not glitter, I'm sorry. And I'm gonna take it on my finger because I just feel like shimmers apply that way better. Look at this color. It looks so gorgeous and I'm gonna place it right in the middle over here. Look at that, it's so fiery, so nice. Just gonna place it on the center where we had no eyeshadow whatsoever. Blending baad mein ho jayega, khali placing finger se karna hai. First shadow brush ke saath wapas se khali blend everything in place. Alright, so now everything looks very monotoned, very nicely blended. All the oranges and browns and crimsons are very nicely there. Abhi agar aapko kahin pe bhi lage na, if anything is lacking, you can always go back. Like over here, I feel like the inner corner has थोड़ा सा that maroon lacking as opposed to this. तो मैं थोड़ा सा build up कर दूंगी in a corner में that maroon shade so that I can get the two eyes matching. Makeup is all about like you know playing along the way. Keep on looking at yourself in the mirror और थोड़ा नमक मिर्च जहाँ पे भी add करना है वो करते जाओ. To add that little pop of glitter, I'm gonna use the Dose of Colors Desi X KT palette. और इसमें ना एक shade है, वो एक shade के लिए मैंने ये पूरा palette खरीदा है. मेरा एक shade टूटा हुआ भी है. Now, if you can see without me dropping my blue shadow over here, can you see? I'm gonna leave like a photo over here for you of what this palette looks like. There's this one shimmer shade, it's called Just a Kiss, and it looks so, so beautiful. It's literally like just a kiss, and it's a shimmery, just a touch of glitter aa jata hai usse. So, just touching that, look at that, just makes the world of a difference to my eyeshadow look. Like it added so much dimension, but it gave that kiss of glitter, and that's exactly what we want with our bridal makeup look. It's subtle, it's not out there shiny, but it's also so beautiful. And I'm putting this exactly where I put that coppery shimmer. Now, Desi X KT palette is not available in India and I think it used to be limited edition. So, ab milega bhi ki nahi, I don't know abroad. Certain alternatives you can use for that is the Stila Glitter and Glow Shadows. I really like them a lot. I have the shade Bronze Bell and looks very, very similar to this. I've used it in a lot of makeup tutorials. And if you want a super cheap and very good alternative, then the Swiss Beauty Glitter Eyeshadows are also great. I have the shade Champagne over here and this is also a great shadow to use just as that glitter topper for your wedding or your bridal or a bridal guest makeup look. Finally, for eyeliner, I'm going to use the Lakme Iconic eyeliner because I don't want to do a wing. I don't think winged eyeliner complements my eyes. It makes it look very small. Again, hooded eye problems. So I'm just going to draw a simple line to cover my lash line. and I want to make it very thin, not bold at all. Okay, now that I'm completely happy with how my eyes look, I'm going to clean up all of this with micellar water and cotton. So I'll be right back. Okay, it's time for base makeup. We are back to the skin. The skin has nicely soaked in all the primer, the moisturizer we put in. So before we dive into foundation, I'm going to give a good spritz of a setting spray so that it just glides on easily. The one I'm using is MAC Fix Plus, and I'm just going to drench my face with that so that my foundation just slides really well on it. And the foundation also I'm using is by MAC. On my wedding day, I'm not gonna, like, you know, play it safe. MAC Studio Fix Fluid looks flawless in photos. It matches my skin tone really well. I'm using the shade NC 43.5. this has been like my exact shade since very long. Not taking too much of the product because we can build up. So, itna sa kuch liya hai maine. With the MAC Studio Fix, I'm mixing my Maybelline Fit Me Matte Plus Poreless. This is in the shade 330 Toffee. And always make sure whenever you're taking foundation, thoda apne se dur rakho, because you know, mere saath kaafi baar aise hadse hue ke while pumping foundation, wo agar tumhare lehenge ke top pe aa gaya to baap re. You can always wear a bathrobe. I suggest and recommend that you wear a bathrobe. I'm mixing these two shades really well. The formulations of both of them individually, both these foundations are bomb, and you can use them individually on your wedding day, but I love the mix of this. And once we have it all dotted, then taking my sponge and blending it all in. Again, with your sponge, go in dabbing motions. Press the foundation into your skin. Don't pull. Agar ek jagah se dusri jagah aisa khichoge na, so you see, ek jagah se dusri jagah tum kaise kharab kar rahe ho, whereas the build up over here. Don't forget your ears, because you cannot have different ears on your wedding day. Photos mein ye sab bahut closely dikhta hai. Isliye just make sure all of the seams are well blended. You're taking foundation down your neck. Even if you want to put it on your back, ask somebody to put foundation on your back, so that all those back shots you get, everything looks seamless and everything is well evened out skin tone wise. Pull your hairline back. Make sure you're blending it into your hairline too. These two foundations I just used are absolutely brilliant. They are like full coverage, but they look so skin-like that you'll not be feeling like you're wearing a heavy face of makeup, and you'll feel super comfortable throughout your day. Even if you want to go for something affordable on your wedding day, it's fine. Use the Maybelline Fit Me. It's a bomb foundation. You can refer to this video up here where I've recommended a lot of good base makeup for y'all. So if you have any confusion whatsoever, you can refer to it over there. I'm gonna pull everything down my neck to make it all look even. Next, for concealer, I'm going back again with the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Eraser Eye, and I'm just gonna place on the inner corner, outer corner, inner corner of the eye, again outer corner. Be careful now because you have your eyeshadow done. Tip of my nose on the V of my forehead, and over here and here. The shade I'm using in this is Caramel, and I'm gonna take the tip of this and very slowly, in slow soft motions, careful around the eye area. You've done your eye makeup, you also don't want to damage the skin around your eye. In pressing motions only, press the concealer into your eye. You can look up if you want, but then how will you do your makeup if you look up? So look in the mirror. If you just go slowly, you can give yourself a seamless finish. I'm gonna take the slightest amount of concealer only on this acne mark that I have over here and a little bit over here. Like thoda sa jo mere foundation se seep through ho raha hai acne marks, I will cover it up with concealer, but the slightest amount, you guys. If you take too much, again, it's gonna be difficult to blend. So just the slightest amount and press that in place. Jahan pe bhi tumko thoda hyperpigmentation ya marks hai, jo tumko cover karna hai. It's not necessary. You can have a natural finish as a bride. You don't have to look like a caked up bride. And now I'm going to set it all in place using powder. So the first thing I'm going to do with my powder, I'm using the Laura Mercier loose powder. You can use the K by Katrina loose powder. It's amazing as well. I love that too. I would definitely use that on my wedding day too, but Laura Mercier has a supremacy in my opinion. And I'm going to take my wet damp beauty sponge, and I'm going to press this first underneath my eyes and keep it here for some time तो इससे तुम्हारा जितना भी कंसीलर है वो प्लेस पे सेट भी हो जाएगा एंड यू विल अवॉइड एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ क्रीसिंग. सो दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज आई कंसीलर क्रीसिंग स्टार्ट्स सबसे पहले. सो आई एम जस्ट गोना अप्लाई इट इन दीज प्लेसेस. ये बहुत ज्यादा पाउडर है, बाद में तुमको डस्ट करना होता है. दिस इज कॉल्ड बेकिंग बट आई एम नॉट बेकिंग फॉर वेरी लॉन्ग. मैक्स आई कीप दिस इज फॉर 5 seconds. आई डोंट वॉन्ट माई अंडर आइज टू लुक वेरी ड्राई ऑल्सो. और उतने में फटाफट आई एम गोना टेक सम क्रीम ब्लश. दिस इज बाय हेना ब्यूटी in the shade Persica. Really like this shade. I'm gonna take it at the back of my hand actually. It's always better to do that rather than directly putting it on your face. Or if bahut product ho gaya to you cannot go back. And taking a little bit on my ring finger, just blending, creating this beautiful shade, and I'm putting it on the high points of my face. Putting a cream blush will give you that naturally flushed sort of a look. It'll look like you're blushing from within, you're a blushing bride. And then I'm gonna blend it all with my sponge. So, jab tak mera powder is doing its magic, my blush has also nicely set into my foundation. And I'm putting it just on the high points of my face, halfway through my cheeks, so that it gives me that dimension and makes me look snatched. Taking a loose powder brush, I'm gonna dust away all of that excess powder we used to set our concealer in place. Looks so smooth, looks like it's filtered skin, and that is why I kept my powder in place for that long. Look at the finish it's giving to my under eyes. Look at the dimension the blush has added to my face. And also this portion where we put our concealer and powder, it just brightens your inner cheek portion. Jitna bhi excess powder hai, usko baaki ke chehre pe bhi laga do. Because baaki ke chehre pe tumne foundation and concealer lagaya hai. You just want to set it with this excess powder. So nothing is going to waste. Next step will be bronzing your skin. I'm using the Ofra Cosmetics bronzer. I'm gonna take this on the pack. Mera brush ka number mit chuka hai, but it's a nice floofy brush and it has an angle to it. So khali ab ye jo blush lagaya tha aur powder lagaya tha uske beech mein you have to place this bronzer and look at the direction. My hand is going like this front and back, adding warmth to my face and it directly adds that shadow and depth you need as well. And now also blending it into my hairline. Because I have a big forehead and that will just help my forehead look smaller in all my wedding photos. Isme itna kuch teer maarne jaisa kaam nahi hai. Bronzer is like the roughest job there is. Bronzer and blush. And a little bit on your nose. For nose contour, you can use like a smaller brush if you want. I have a pretty sleek nose in general, so I don't want a very sharp contour. So I just roughly take my bronzer, gives it that little bit of warmth and dimension, and that's good enough for me. Blush is done. Last step in the base routine is the highlighter. You need that bling in your wedding photos, of course, along with your jewelry. Your face has to glow too. I'm using the Wet n Wild Precious Petals highlighter. It's a bomb highlighter. It has just the right amount of glow and it's not chunky at all. Look at how beautifully it sits on your skin. When I mean chunky, it's basically like jo aapka skin ka texture hai, wo highlighter bahut easily emphasize karta hai. So if you have acne, if you have skin texture on your wedding day, it's fine. Even though if you do good skincare, it should like go away, at least skin texture should. But a highlighter like this is so smooth that it will not emphasize any like bad skin if you have any. Just applying it on my tip of my nose, on my cupid's bow, pout a little. Bomb honey. Now completing the eye look, I'm gonna first fill in my brows. I'm using the Miniso eyebrow pencil. Indians tend to have good bushy eyebrows. Just get it threaded before your wedding, of course, or if you shave them at home, pluck them at home. Jo bhi karwana hai, jo bhi excess baal hai, you can get them removed. The shade I'm using is 02 dark brown. What I like to do with my brow pencil is just fill in the gaps that I have. Brows also make or break the game, so make sure your makeup artist does not do super bold eyebrows, like black eyebrows on you. It looks super hideous in your photos. You need to make sure it's like a shade of brown so that it blends well into your skin. Even though you feel your hair color is black, use a brown shadow because you can play around more with it. A brown can always build up to a black, but a black can never be toned down. So that's the freaking problem. See what a filled brow as opposed to a non-filled brow looks. Taking my spoolie brush, this is from Morphe, and I'm gonna brush my hair upwards. जो भी एक्सेस प्रोडक्ट होगा मेरे आईब्रो हेयर्स में वो ये स्पूली ब्रश पे आ जाएगा. ये अलग से भी मिलता है, यू गेट इट लाइक द मस्कारा ब्रश. इट्स कॉल्ड अ स्पूली. यू जस्ट नीड टू कॉम थ्रू योर आईब्रोज वंस after you've applied any sort of product on it. One last time I'm gonna spritz my face with the MAC Fix Plus to lock all my makeup in place, drenching myself in this. and then I'm gonna pick up any excess product I have with the butt of my beauty sponge, so that agar bahut powder lag gaya ho, kahin bahut blush lag gaya hai, bronzer lag gaya hai, highlighter, everything will come on the sponge, and then my skin will just look like one filter. Trust me, after this base routine, I have slept and gotten up, and nothing will transfer to your pillow cover also. I can guarantee you that. Like, if you follow these steps to the T, then nothing is going to transfer. It's going to be transfer proof. So if you have a long wedding wherein, you know, after feras, you have to change and thoda beech mein sona hai, to so bhi jao. Aur kuch nahi hoga tumhare makeup ko. To complete my eyes, I'm taking the MAC Extreme Dimension Black Kohl. Koi bhi black kajal le lo and you can draw on your waterline. If you don't like kajal, if you don't want to apply it, it's completely your call. But I love how my eyes look with kajal. Look at the depth it gives me. You want to look your best on your wedding day. To complete my eye look on the lower lash line, I'm going to go back again with this maroon brown, which we used the maximum in this eye look. And usi ko niche lower lash line pe I will smoke out. For my inner corner, I'm taking this golden shadow and I'm going to place this right in my inner corner to add that bling and open up my eyes. Of course, I'm going to do false lashes, but I'll quickly take a coat of the Maybelline Falsies mascara and apply that on my lashes. For lashes, I'm using Henna Henna Beauty in the style Amira. I really like their lashes because they last really long also. Use their lashes on a lot of occasions. These are nice, floofy. They complement my eyes really well, make them look open. Taking the Pack Lash Fixer, I'm gonna apply a very thin coat of that on the band. I do have a tutorial on how you can apply your false lashes, like a dedicated tutorial on that. So I will link it up in the eye. And you can check it out. For the last and final step, that is lipstick, I'm going to use a nude lip because we've done such a smoky, glittery, bold eye look. And our lehenga is going to be super heavy as well. Jewelry is heavy, so I want the lips to be muted. A lot of brides do prefer red and pink lipstick. To each one's own, whatever you prefer, go for that. I'm going to go with a nude lip. I'm using the Pack Lip Pencil in Coffee to just outline my lips and give them dimension. I'm going to top up with Kat Von D's Lolita 2. This is my favorite nude of all times, but I'm going to use a lot of lipstick combos. Before this sets matte, I'm going to mix a little bit of the Calabar Hot Latte also. Be prepped, this is the perfect nude I'm working on. I love this combination of lippies. Finally, what I'll throw in my purse will be like a K-Beauty Cameo lipstick because I love the formulation on this. It's very hydrating. So on the go, if I feel like these liquid lipsticks have made my lips very dry, then this is the perfect nude shade to complement it all. So this will be like my throw-in touch-up lipstick. That completes it, you guys. This is my bridal makeup look all complete. Of course, adorn all your bridal jewelry. I feel like such a bride right now. I can literally go right now and get married, just that I have nobody to get married to. All my beautiful and gorgeous jewelry is from Silver Plaza Original, and my gorgeous lehenga has been custom made by the clothing rack. I will make sure to link everything in the description box for you, so don't forget to check it out. Let me know, what do you think about this bridal makeup look? Would you do something like this for your wedding, or would you go for like a muted eye and a red bold lip? I really want to know in the comment section, what kind of a bride are you? If you like this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. It really helps with the algorithm. For today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Behsha Ki Karan. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button, bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, adding a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, love you.